Hi, my name is Ellen Mazel from the CVI Center at Perkins, and this is a discussion about the assessment area of appearance of the eye. So what is appearance of the eye? Children with CVI often have few noticeable eye abnormalities, but one thing that's often noticeable is their eye alignment difficulties, strabismus, and it's often present. And these conditions and the functions will vary in each individual child. Children can have stable eye turns in various directions, or it can increase when the child is visually fatigued, ill, or overwhelmed. In this image, this child's eye alignment is perfectly centered. We're able to look at the reflection in those eyes and see that it appears in exactly the same place in both eyes. This tells us this eye alignment is perfect for this child. Children with CVI can have a wide variety of types of strabismus. They can have esotropia, where eyes turn inward, exotropia, where eyes turn outward, hyperopia, where eyes tilt upwards, or hypotropia, where the eyes tilt downwards, and any combination can be true. Very common in CVI is strabismus with alternating eye alignment, where it's not a stable condition all the time, but actually alternates between the eyes. We also put this under movement of the eyes in our assessment. And this alternation is often dependent on the type of task or the type of environment. It can become much more pronounced with fatigue and illness or when the child is overwhelmed. And it can be a function noted in all severity levels of CVI. What the research tells us is that strabismus is a frequently coexisting condition for individuals with CVI. Individuals with CVI often have this intermittent or alternating eye use, and strabismus is able to be clinically measured. Glasses or surgery can often help with this eye alignment, and if that is not treated, if strabismus is not treated, that can lead to amblyopia, or one of the eyes, the vision that is weaker actually shuts down the visual information. So how does strabismus impact vision? Learners will need more time to view what is being presented when they have strabismus. They'll need to find and use their best eye and their best head positions in order to access the learning environment. They will struggle with shift of gaze, so copying should be limited. They will miss information in certain visual fields depending on where their eyes are turned. They will need increased contrast in presentations and learning. When we listen to the voices of parents with CVI, this CVI parent says, "My daughter has both strabismus and CVI. Watching her, I think she self-manages the strabismus using only one eye at a time. She seems to pick the better eye for a given task, and the one she isn't using can wander." An adult with CVI tells us that definitely things like depth perception and all that was tough. I had strabismus surgery and it changed my eye alignment. Unfortunately, it didn't correct things because I had strabismus in three directions and three types of double vision. Things were double side by side, one above the other, and then they were tilted. It was like this all the time and I couldn't turn it off. Trying to navigate the three types of double vision was terrifying. I remember I was in a car with my cousin once, and we were in slow-moving traffic, inching along, but to me, it looked like she was crashing into another car. I remember freaking out because I thought we were going to die in that car. And it was like, oh no, that's just my double vision lying to me again. It was a constant world where I couldn't trust anything I was seeing. I didn't know where things were, and I completely missed things coming at me. I got hit by the ball so many times in school. This is some of our most current research about this topic area. Here's some other resources you might be interested in reading about. Every child with CVI is teachable, and every child has the right to a meaningful and accessible education.